In this question, we're looking at an issue of rainfall in the Sydney area. From the years 2000 to 2007, we have 8 readings of annual rainfall in millimeters. And we're interested in determining whether this rainfall is significantly below or above the long-term average. The long-term average is 1,302 millimeters. All right, so in order to determine this, we're going to use what's called a sine test from elementary probability and statistics. So we're going to use a sine test. So we have 8 readings. And from these 8 readings, we have a look to see how many of them are above and how many of them are below this long-term average. So let's just put little pluses and minuses along them. So comparing to 1300, this is below, this is above, this is below, 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 and this one is above. So out of the 8 readings, we have 2 pluses, and we have 6 minuses. And we'd like to ask the question, well, from this, can we deduce that, in fact, the long-term average is kind of shifting? Or whether is this perhaps just due to luck? So what is the probability of this occurring just due to luck? Well, in order to figure that out, we have to look at the underlying sort of model here for sort of tossing a coin. So the binomial distribution is the relevant one. So this is the BNPK distribution. And this is, first of all, I'll write down what the value is. So BNPK is N choose K, P to the K, and 1 minus P to the N minus K. And what this represents is, this is the probability of getting K heads from N tosses of a P-weighted coin. That means where the probability of a head is a P. So what we're going to do is look at this situation as basically a coin tossing event. So the probability of getting 2 or fewer heads from 8 tosses of a fair coin, because basically we're assuming that the probability of getting more than the long-term average equals the probability of getting less than the long-term average. Both of those are equally likely. So getting 2 or fewer heads from 8 tosses when P equals a half. Well, we're going to write that as a binomial distribution expression. So that's the sum from k equals 0 to 2 of n choose k. N is 8, so 8 choose k. P is a half, so it's a 1 half to the k. And then 1 minus p will also be a half, so that'll be 1 half to the 8 minus k. Because of the special nature we have p equals a half, this simplifies, because we have 1 over 2 to the k and 1 over 2 to the 8 minus k, so altogether that's 1 over 2 to the 8. That can come up front. And then we're talking about the sum from k equals 0 to 2 of 8 choose k. So what is that? Well, 8 choose 0 is 1. 8 choose 1 is 8. And 8 choose 2 is 8 times 7 all over 2, that's 28. So altogether we get 9 plus 28 is 37, so that's 37 over 2 to the 8. And 2 to the 8 is 256. And what kind of probability is that? Well, that's somewhere between maybe around between 10 and 15%. So this is a probability that's around somewhere between 10 and 15%, which is relatively low. So we would expect that this is not very likely due to chance, but this is not such a small probability either. So it could be due to chance. So it's, well, let's say, to be on the safe side, it's unlikely, but could be due to chance. There's an aspect of ambiguity in these kinds of tests. Often we're not able to, you know, make a solid prediction, but we're getting a ballpark estimate for whether something's likely or not. So in this case, it looks like, from this data, that the long-term average has perhaps shifted, but it's not an ironclad conclusion.